So I'll just do a super quick explainer on some issues you might run into if you've been using a Ledger wallet for a while, particularly if you're using the old Ethereum Chrome app or something like that, and you've now moved onto Ledger Live, or perhaps you started on the Ledger app and then moved to MyEtherWallet and found yourself struggling to find coins and addresses and things that you for sure you had and maybe you were using in the past. But anyway, and essentially what I want to do is just, I guess, demonstrate what this article on GitHub is about. And essentially, if you have a look at it, you'll see that this is someone making a comment that Ledger Live uses a different style to derive its Ethereum addresses. And that's all well and good, but it can mean that you might not immediately find your coins where you think you left them. And also, just want to show you how to make sense of some of the options that you're given on MyEtherWallet and on the new, both in the vintage interface, which I'm most familiar, as well as the new one as well. So essentially, if you're using, what I've done is actually just create some accounts on Ledger Live, and we've got three accounts that we're going to use. And that one there, first of all, is number 0, so it's a Ledger Chrome legacy account. So if you just installed the Ledger Chrome app on, you know, back before Ledger Live, and we're just using that, this is going to be that we're representing where those coins will live. And fortunately, Ledger Live seems to now find them when you say add account, and just it'll put like a legacy bracket behind them. I've also got created two accounts using the new Ledger Live sort of derivation method, and I'll explain how that works in a sec. Number 1 and number 2, and I've put a different balance in each one just to make them nice and easy to see and to not get confused in terms of how that's all going. And I just wanted to show you how these three addresses, both the old Ledger Chrome app one and the two Ledger Live ones, correspond to what you're going to find in MyEtherWallet if that's what you're using. So here we go. So basically, first of all, I thought we'd just start with this principle again of how these wallets work, in the sense that you've got a single seed and all the different keys are derived from that. And what is used to determine what those keys are is basically this derivation path. Because if you've been hanging around crypto for a while, you'll see in your wallets these numbers like your M4460, and in MyEtherWallet originally it had all these options, so, and that was listed as Ledger Ethereum, and you can see there's an address of 0.01 ETH, and that's actually the same one as here. So this Ledger ETH is actually probably more correctly should be labeled as, you know, Ledger Chrome app or something like that, because this no longer represents how ledgers work if you're using Ledger Live. So that's an easy way to run into trouble. But if we actually go to the advanced logs on the account, we can see as well here that this derivation path of 4460, and then that last letter, sorry, that last zero corresponds to this spot here. So that would be 0, that would be 1, 2, 3 as you incremented this last digit, but that's the derivation path you can see there. So it's an address starting with 3BF0334, and I've actually got it open in Etherscan here as well, so you can see that's the one with 0.001 ETH. Now if you open the new MyEtherWallet interface and select you've got a Ledger, you'll actually be presented with this choice here. Do you want Ethereum or do you want Ledger Live? And again, it's important to note that it's the default behavior of MyEtherWallet is for basically the old Ledger Chrome app, not Ledger Live. So, you know, for this checkbox here, you might be thinking, you know, what's this mean? Is this two separate coins? No, this is just two different ways to deal with derivation paths. Because again, you can see these same numbers, M4460, and then that one there has one less as well. So if we just select Ethereum, what that will do is give us this screen here. make sure we have it there, so we'll just close that. And you can see again the addresses that it's getting are what would be the original Chrome app. So there's that one, starts with EBF 0334 with a balance of 0.001. Now, where things get a bit confusing is if you're trying to use like the old MyEtherWallet interface, so like the vintage MyEtherWallet interface, which a lot of stuff will still link to, then you're going to need to use some different derivation paths. So firstly, and these derivation paths will be based on how many accounts you've added in Ledger Live. So fortunately for you, if you've only added one account in Ledger Live with the new address format, you can just select the derivation path here, which is actually, it says Jack's MetaMask. No mention of Ledger whatsoever, but that's the Ledger Live one, basically, if you're just using this old style of MyEtherWallet. And you can see there that corresponds to 0.02 ETH. Go away. And we can also see I've got that one open there in Etherscan, so you could view any token balances and those sorts of things. And if we go into the new MyEtherWallet, I'll just close it and start again from scratch. So this is the standard, this is the default interface now, this new one. And you select your ledger, yes. And then we say, oh, that all appeared because I clicked that. So we then said we want Ledger Live and say next. It's going to present us with this list of addresses. So you can see there again, that's the one starting with an 89, which is the same as this one here. Though, this is the important thing to note, is that how sequential addresses work in Ledger Live does not correspond to how sequential addresses work and stuff in MyEtherWallet. So how your normal, well, it's less normal in Ethereum, but how normal with Bitcoin and other things work is they'll increment this last digit here. So you can sort of see these are, as I explained before, so you'd have the derivation path for this first address is M44600, and then there's 0, and then another 0 at the end. And for things like Bitcoin and stuff, normally this last digit is the one that would be incremented. But with Ledger Live, they've got a different approach, which is that you'll notice it's this third number here that's incremented as you change accounts. So every account you add increments this. That behavior is fairly normal, or sort of normal. What I would expect in other systems would be that this is the digit here that increments as you add accounts, and then every address that's derived is this one here. But Ledger have decided this is the one they're going to increment, so that's why things may not behave as you would expect as you try and go finding other accounts. So if we wanted to find, say, the first account, so instead of just incrementing this digit here, we actually have to increment the second one. So if we click that, it'll actually show us, you can see that is the 0.03 ETH. So if you're using the older style of MyEtherWallet, you will have to manually go editing your derivation paths to correspond to different accounts that you've found in the new, or added in the new Ledger Live. The old one pretty much just created one account and just used that address for everything. And again, you'll notice with Ethereum, unlike Bitcoin, it doesn't just give you a new address every time you hit receive. It'll essentially just keep giving you the same one over and over again. And then that's just to do with the difference of how things like change are implemented in between Bitcoin and Ethereum. But fortunately, MyEtherWallet is smart enough that they've made it so that it, when you select Ledger Live as your address type, will correctly find all of the accounts that you're wanting to use. So basically, this is mostly just about if you're stuck trying to use the old MyEtherWallet interface with Ledger Live, or if for whatever reason you can't find your coins in Ledger Live and they were for an old wallet. Likewise, if for some odd reason you did select a different derivation path when you had your, when you, I guess, set up your initial Ethereum wallet, so say you didn't use Ledger Live or didn't use the old Chrome app, you know, you'll have to use that same one to find your address. So if you're unsure, the good thing about, or at least what I like about this old style of MyEtherWallet, is you can very quickly click through different derivation paths to try and work out, you know, where are your coins, in a way that's not necessarily straightforward. That said, again, the new Ledger Live, the latest version I was using now, does seem to do a much better job of finding those old legacy accounts than some of the earlier versions of Ledger Live. So there you go, that's good to know. But again, the key thing though is that to be able to spend your Ethereum, you're gonna have to find the addresses that you were using, and you're gonna need to know what your derivation path was to be able to get these addresses out the other end. Because again, once you've found them, then it's very straightforward just to send them with MyEtherWallet, you know, wherever you like. So you can just basically find it, go, yes, that was the right one, fantastic, let's unlock our wallet and sweep those funds into a new address that works natively with whatever wallet you might happen to be using is. So there you go. I hope that's clarified a little bit about how derivation paths work and how they can be useful to try and find different coins that you might think you've lost or be struggling to get access to. So there you go. Give us a question. Leave a question if you've got any other comments. But yeah, it's pretty straightforward once you get your head around it. But yeah, definitely not intuitive to start with. So best of luck. And yeah, let us know how it goes.